Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss about welding. Welding is a joining process. Welding is the process of joining similar or dissimilar metal with or without application of pressure and with or without use of filler metal. Weld may be defined as coalescence of metal produced by heating to a suitable temperature with or without application of pressure and with or without use of filler metal. Fusion of metal takes place by means of heat. Heat may be obtained by blacksmith fire, electric arc, electric resistance, or by chemical reaction. Process of joining similar metal by melting the edge together without addition of filler metal is known as autogenous welding. Process of joining similar metal with the help of filler rod of same metal is called homogeneous welding. Process of joining dissimilar metal with the help of filler rod is called heterogeneous welding. Now, types of welding. Weld can be classified into two categories mainly. One is forge or pressure welding. Second one is fusion or non-pressure welding. In forge or pressure welding, material are to be heated to a plastic state and then they are joined together by applying pressure on them. In this case, no filler material is used. Example, blacksmith forge welding, friction welding, electric resistance welding. Example of electric resistance welding are spot welding, seam welding, projection welding, percussion welding, upset butt welding, and flash butt welding. Now, next process are fusion and non-pressure welding. In this process, material are joined together by using a filler rod. Filler rod are melted at a temperature above the melting point of the metal and then allowed to solidify. Example of fusion or non-pressure welding are electric arc welding, chemical reaction welding, gas welding. Example of electric arc welding are carbon arc welding, manual metal arc welding, tungsten inert gas welding, metal inert gas welding, submerged arc welding, etc. Example of gas welding is oxyacetylene gas welding. Example of chemical reaction welding are thermit welding. Now, types of welded joint. There are basically five types of joint are widely used in welding. First is lap joint, butt joint, corner joint, T joint, edge joint. Lap joint is obtained by overlapping the plate and then welding the edge of two plates. This type of joint are employed for the plate having thickness less than 3 mm. Lap joint is obtained by overlapping the plate and then welding the edge of the two plate. This type of joint are employed for the plate having thickness less than 3 mm. If we place the plate in this way, an electrode is passed in this direction, the joint form is said to be a lap joint, single lap joint. On the other side, if we do a welding, then this is said to be a double lap joint. Butt joint is obtained by welding the edge of the two plates, which are approximately in the same plane, like this. Corner joint, edge joint, T joint are the another type of the joint which are widely used in welding. Now, position of welding. There are four positions: flat position, vertical position, overhead position, and horizontal position. Flat position, welding is done from upper side of the weld and face of the weld is remain horizontal. If you do the welding under the side of the joint, under the side of the joint and face of the weld is remain horizontal, then this is said to be a overhead welding. Horizontal position welding, weld is deposited upon a horizontal against a vertical surface. In a vertical welding, welding line is in vertical plane and weld is deposited upon against a vertical surface. Arc welding, mainly we have a manual metal arc welding, metal inert gas welding, tungsten inert gas welding, submerged arc welding setup in our laboratory. All are arc welding process. Arc welding, in this process, welding heat is obtained from an electric arc between metal electrode and workpiece. Welding current, welding arc is produced between the metal electrode and workpiece. The arc is produced when two conductors of electric circuit are touched together and then they are separated by a short distance, such that there is sufficient voltage in the circuit to maintain the flow of current through gaseous medium. Both alternate current and direct current are used for arc welding. Direct current source are DC generator, which is driven by electric motor, petrol or diesel engine. Our alternate current source are step down transformer, which receive voltage from 220 to 440 volt and transform it to 80 to 100 volt for striking the arc, and maintaining the arc it should be lower, that is to be 30 to 40 volt. Now, polarity in arc welding. When work is connected to negative terminal and electrode is connected to positive terminal, this is said to be in reverse, work, this is said to be in reverse polarity. Here, electrode is connected to positive terminal of arc welding machine, manual metal arc welding machine, and work is connected to positive terminal of DC machine, and electrode is connected to negative terminal of DC machine. This work set, then we say this work setup is in state polarity. Basically, we have manual metal arc welding setup and MIG welding setup in our laboratory. Manual metal arc welding setup. In manual metal arc welding, welding heat is obtained from an electric arc, which is produced in between workpiece and electrode. State piece of wire, this is state piece of wire about 45 centimeter long and 1.5 millimeter to 10 millimeter in diameter, which are widely used in manual metal arc welding. In MIG, metal inert gas welding is similar to tungsten inert gas welding, except electrode are consumable. Solid wire of desired composition from 0.8 millimeter to 1.5 millimeter diameter is continuously and automatically feed from a reel at a speed of 250 centimeter to 750 centimeter per minute. Weld is deposited, weld is completely sealed by atmosphere of inert gas. Next part of the lecture will be delivered by Sri Gautam Nandi sir. Thank you.
My name is Dr. Gautam Nandi. Before myself, Professor Nobindu Ghosh has described about the main welding process. What is welding? What types of welding is available in the market? But there are some tidbits of welding. That is, this particular, I will tell you the different names of the welding. This is known as electrode holder, through which it is connected with the transformer. And this is electrode, not only electrode, rather it is known as coated electrode. Initially, when the welding was started, basically it was bare electrode. At present, some coating is done. What's the purpose of coating? I will tell you after some time. This electrode was held into the electrode holder. Basically, one thing Nobindu Babu has not told to you, basically it's a short circuit technique. If it is a short circuit technique, if the machine is on, if I touch the electrode and standing on the bare foot of the earth, certainly I may be electrocuted. But no one is electrocuted by this process. What is the reason behind it? Reason is that basically, if it is a short circuit technique, it has got one characteristic: low voltage, high current. Human body can bear maximum 50 amounts of volt. So in this circuit, the lesser the voltage is available, so that no one will be electrocuted. And why the purpose of the coating was given into the electrode? When welding is going there, certainly there should be liquefaction of the two elements from the two sides. When it will be solidified, certainly ambient oxygen, nitrogen and hydrogen may be included, which creates the defects in the welding. There are varieties of defects you might expect during welding. And to prevent the natural occlusion of hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen, we create some fume through this electrode. Some elements has been given over there so that it will create a fume into the weld zone, so that ambient oxygen nitrogen will not be entered into the weld zone. Suppose I want to add chromium. It is not possible to add chromium directly into the weld zone. Rather, we can use through this thing. And you please see, this is a solid electrode. There are another type of electrode are available. This is known as coated electrode. Rather, another electrode is available, which is known as cored electrode. That means the electrode is hollow. Within this hollow portion, another element has been introduced so that may directly come to the weld zone. And another, the position. Can you tell me whether this electrode, which has already told by Nobindu Babu, different position, horizontal position, vertical means top to lower portion, and overhead welding, that is the top portion, the connection between the roof and the walls, whether this electrode can be applied for overhead welding? What should be the problem we may rise? The problem is that due to the gravitational force, the droplet which will go to the overhead position, that will come to the body of the welder, creating a lot of problems. So what do you do basically? We change the electrode. That means in another sense, there are different types of electrodes are available in the market. I want to mean that is a specification of the electrode through which the droplet which will come to the gravity, rather it will go against gravity and it will join on the corner joint, which is known as overhead welding. And not only that, how should we select the types of electrode? First, we have to select the material which you want to work. Second point is that amount of deposition rate. If the weld zone needs more and more liquid material, we have to use thicker weld zone. Except this, whether what type of slag will be produced. After this, the position of the welding. After this, what are the two different materials are going to be welded? Depending all these parameters, we have to select the basically types of electrode. So after that, Nobindu Babu has told some gas welding, electric arc welding, TIG welding, MIG welding, and he has also told you submerged arc welding. What is basically submerged arc welding? Basically, submerged means, I think when you go by the roadside, you see there are so many grill companies as well as car finishing company, they are using different type of welding. One is mainly the car manufacturer used, that is gas welding, that is mixture of oxygen and acetylene. And in case of grill company, they use electric arc welding. Where lies the difference? Why in case of car welding, in most of the cases, gas welding is preferred, not the electric arc welding. So, selection of this electrode also depend upon the thickness of the material. If the thickness is higher, we can recommend this electric arc welding. If the thickness is very small, the gas welding is preferred. According to Nobendu Babu, he has uttered one positive, one negative, it is applicable for DC source. The actual meaning, that is DCSP, what does it mean basically? That is direct current straight polarity. Another one is DCRP, direct current reverse polarity. These are the advantage of DC machine. This advantage is not available in AC machines. So far my knowledge is concerned. What is the advantage? Suppose the thickness of the material is very thin. If it is so, we have to weld by electric arc welding. If it is also so, we have to select the type of the electrode as well as polarity. We, with the help of this electrode tip, we should start arc over here and go for the welding. There are, if the temperature at the tip is higher, if the temperature of the tip is higher, certainly this thin plate will be melted within a very short period of time. If the temperature in the job is higher, certainly the temperature which should be raised over here less. So certainly depending upon the thickness of the material, we can change either straight polarity or reverse polarity. It is available for DC gen set, normally DC generator set. What is the, suppose Farakka bridge is going to be constructed, it was constructed in 1970 most probably. And the recommendation was, that is electric arc welding. From where you will get the power so that you can go for the electric arc welding? When is going to be built the Farakka barrage, there was no availability of power. So DC genset may be recommended so that we can generate power over here. Sitting there, you can go for the welding. These are the advantages of DC motor genset. Next, the next question comes whether when this will produce arc, if I touch the material, certainly it will melt, it will stick to the base material. Then what we can do? This is our first target. We should initiate the arc initially. After that, the electrode should be keep some 2 to 3 millimeters away from the job where we are going to be weld. How the welding will be continued? If you touch it, basically short circuit technique, it will create arc. If you remove the electrode from the job, how the electricity will be continued? The mechanism that the ions which is present over here, that should be ionized and it will maintain the electricity. And there are, we can tell it, certainly when we should go for the practical training, we should go for the different experiments. Suppose this electrode was immersed into the water. Suppose this electrode was immersed into the water. You are going to weld with this electrode. I think you won't be able to go for the welding because there is some problem. We should do it in our class when the practical class is going to be, not virtually, rather practically face to face. Another, for this only, so that the water content in the electrode should be controlled, there is some furnace where it is recommended electrode should be kept in the furnace. Except this thing, TIG welding, what is the full form of TIG welding? Tungsten inert gas welding. What is the full form of MIG welding? Metal inert gas welding. What is the full form of SAW? Submerged arc welding. Why it is known as submerged? I have uttered just 5 minutes ago. Submerged means the welding, where is going to be done, that you cannot see. You can see the welding roadside, that is spark of the welding is going on, in gas welding also. But when submerged working is going on, you cannot see the weld zone. What is the reason behind it? Is there any improvement of the quality? First thing, submerged arc welding is recommended for heavy thickness, at least more than 10 to 12 millimeter and above. And the metal deposition rate is very higher. The last point is that as it is in submerged condition, it's a no question arises for the inclusion of hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen into the well zone, as well as it gives a good performance in the, and how the welding, the last point is that how the welding is tested, that is the testing of the material and defects of welding. What are the common defects of the welding? That is porosity, inclusion, reactor, or different types of welding defects are present into the material. It should be our target that the weld should be defectless. In another word, we can tell it, that is a sound welding is to be done. Nobindu Bahu has shown you different position. If we keep the material, that is we are making to make a T joint, making a T joint. Either you can go for this side or both the side. So how you should express it in drawing? Suppose welding is to be done in the field, not into this workshop. Certainly, in case of technical people by engineers, we have got one language, that is engineer's language. We have got some symbols. On the welding, if we put some symbols, that is known to us, that seeing the symbol, it should be clear to us that welding should be done in the field, not in the workshop, as well as what type of joint you want to, that is different symbols which you read in engineering drawing classes. That is, different types of symbols means whether it is one-sided joint, double-sided joint, whether it is lap joint or something else, it should be reflected in the engineering drawing. So now, we are going to go for the at first electric arc welding. Subroto Koyal, who is a very close to our this welding lamp, he will go for the practical cases. Initially, he will complete the electric arc welding or manual metal arc welding. After that, he will complete metal inert gas welding. The last point, what's the function of the inert gas? That is the same thing. In case of submerged arc welding, there is no probability of occlusion of ambient hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. But in case of MIG welding, this gas creates a fume on the weld zone so that the quality of welding should be better. That's all now. Subroto Koyal will give the practical demonstration.
Electric arc welding going on, how to for it?
You please sit. I am
striking there. Striking there and welding is going on. Welding is end. This is welding portion and this is back side. And this is called it welding hammer, basigel hammer and striking it. Coating is removed after welding. This is.
Hello, Subroto Babu. Initially, the welding which was performed by Subroto Babu with a definite particular current condition. Now, I want this was the condition of the weld job which was performed having a definite particular ampere. Now what Subrata Babu has done, he has increased the current. Now we are going to see what is the condition of the well. This is our target. Well quality should be such it should be defect free or a sound welding. Now it has got some arrangement so that it increase current. Now we are increasing the current and we want to see the performance of the welding as well as the quality of the welding. Subrata, you please do it. Where lies the difference? This was the initial position with low current. Now this is the position having higher current. Only the difference, if you can see through it, that is the penetration. If you increase the current, penetration rate will be higher. So depending upon the thickness of the material, we should go for the setting of the amount of current so that it will not melt the whole material. Rather two materials, basically it's a bar joint, both of the materials should be melted and after solidification the coalescence should be produced. Thank you all about this thing.
Now we are stand in front of MIG welding machine. MIG, full form of MIG is metal inert gas welding. Commonly it is also known as GMAW welding. Depend upon which type of gas we are used. If CO2 gas is used, then its name is changed to GMAW. If inert gas is used like argon, helium, then we say it is metal inert gas welding. Here in our workshop, welding shop, we have argo seal as a inert gas. Equipment which are used to do MIG welding are gas cylinder. The flow rate of the gas is measured by this meter. This is main machine, welding machine. Before welding, we have to set the parameter of the welding, that is current, voltage, wire feed rate. We have to set before the welding take place. Now we have already discussed what is butt joint. Butt joint is obtained by overlapping the plate, is obtained by placing the plate approximately in the same plane, and lap joint is obtained by overlapping the plate. Now we see how we prepare a butt joint by MIG. First, we have to clean the piece of metal by using wire brush and then place it on a welding table. After that, we set the welding parameter on welding machine and then we make a single pass of weld over the plate. Finally, weld is made. Now, Mr. Subrata Koyal will demonstrate how butt joint is made by using MIG welding. Mr. Subrata, please. Now, Mr. Subroto has shown you how per joint is look ওসাটা করতে হবে না করতে হবে না করতে হবে ডাকছি Now this is the butt joint we have made by using MIG welding process. It is a single pass welding. Thank you.
Now you please see about the different kinds of welding flames. On the left hand side, these three indicates the different types of welding flames, and on the right hand side, these three types of flames are known as gas cutting flames, so that with the help of oxygen and acetylene, we go for the gas welding. Parallelly, with the help of oxygen and acetylene, we can cut the material also. So, for welding, oxygen and acetylene are mixing in different ratio. If it is 1:1 ratio, that is 1% oxygen and 1% acetylene, the flame which is produced, that is known as neutral flame. In most of the cases, we use this type of neutral flames in case of gas welding. Now, there is only other way. You may decrease the amount of oxygen, that amount of acetylene is increased. That is known as reducing flame or carburizing flame, or you can increase the oxygen, that is known as oxidizing flame. But how a welder will recognize which is oxidizing, which is neutral and which is carburizing flame? He can see the types of flames only. By seeing the flames only, he can recognize whether it is a neutral acetylene, whether it is a reducing flame or whether it is oxidizing flame, that is the amount of oxygen is higher. So, by seeing the nature of the flames, he can differentiate about the oxidizing flame, neutral flame and carburizing flame. Parallelly, you please see the gas cutting. This inner portion of the cone, you please see it is straight. That means through which there is a separate nozzle. In case of gas cutting flame, there is a similarly blue flame, that is excess of oxygen is coming, which helps to cut the material. Parallelly, the inner flame, you please see, for oxyacetylene, that is amount of oxygen is very low. If it is a neutral flame, amount of oxygen with small tip, amount excess of oxygen, excess is increasing, and that is excess of acetylene. You please see, that is three cones are produced. In these two things, only two cones are there, the larger cone and the smaller cone, and the another green cone is coming. Similarly, the torch which is commonly used for gas welding is not used for gas cutting also. And you please see the different figures of the gas cutting flames and gas welding flames. Parallelly, which I have told earlier about the different symbols which has been used. This is fillet weld, this is lap weld, this is corner weld, this is double corner weld. We put it in engineering drawing so that we can recognize in the field what type of joint should be produced.